welcome to another episode of the Global Leadership Series. Today we have a very special guest with us, the former President and former Army Chief of Pakistan, General Pervez Musharraf. General Musharraf, welcome to WION.
Thank you very much.
I want to start, sir, with what's been making headlines in your country, in Pakistan. Nawaz Sharif's stunning admission. He said that 26/11 was orchestrated and carried out by non-state actors in Pakistan, and the establishment has been dragging its feet on the case. Is it time that the government and the army of Pakistan dropped this farce and admitted that this attack, the worst attack on Indian soil, was carried out from Pakistan?
Well, I think this is absolutely wrong. We shouldn't take whatever Nawaz Sharif is saying on its merit at all. I don't think that is the fact.
What is the fact then, sir? Was Ajmal Kasab not a Pakistani? Were his handlers not Pakistani?
No, I don't think so. I don't think so, and I don't know.
I know.
What is Ajmal Kasab? He's an ordinary man. You give him two slaps and he'll tell you everything.
He's dead. He came from Faridkot in Pakistan, and that has been established.
You can make him do anything. You can make him say anything.
He's dead, sir.
These things happen. Well, he is. I mean, are you for a moment agreeing with what Kulbashan Yadav is, who we've got, that he's your agent, that he's been doing sabotage in Pakistan? You're not saying that. You're not admitting, isn't it?
I think you're mixing up two cases.
I'm talking about
the 26/11 case, sir, and there's been a pile of proof handed over to Pakistan. Now, a former prime minister, three-time prime minister of Pakistan, is saying that Pakistani agents were involved. You cannot take his word lightly only because you're saying you do not think that Pakistan was involved.
Yes, no, it was not involved as a government. But if somebody on his own, some organization or some group does carried out something, it's not the responsibility of Pakistan government. You throw the blame on Pakistan government and the Pakistan army. And the person you are quoting is also trying to, at this moment, malign the army and the establishment.
So you are at one level admitting that there might be players beyond the control of the Pakistan army and the government who may have had a role to play in the Mumbai attack. Having said that, let me ask you then, is it not the duty and responsibility of an elected government, a responsible country, to bring such people to book? Not a single person has been put behind bars pending trial in this case.
Listen, now you have got involved in an issue which RAW does equally, if not more, in Pakistan. And you just want to talk about and malign Pakistan, that we are the only culprits and you are angels, you don't do anything. So please understand that this is happening, and please also understand that since 1990, when you cracked down in Kashmir, there have been volunteer groups here, people wanting to go into Kashmir to defend their brethren and give their lives for that. This has been the situation in Pakistan.
I don't know
why
you're digressing,
sir.
They
came up, they sprung up themselves. They are prepared to go to Kashmir.
I am giving you a specific case of the worst terror attack on Indian soil.
What do you mean, generality? No,
I mean people in Pakistan.
No, well, and when I quoted Yadav, you suddenly said, "No, you're not talking of that." Why? Why are you not talking of him?
I will talk about
him. I want to talk of him.
Okay.
Because he is specific. Sorry?
I will talk about Jadhav.
Oh,
let me tell you
about both. On that side, we don't know. We don't know who did.
No. I'll tell you. A former ISI chief has said that Pakistan should have returned Kulbhushan Jadhav at the right price. What does that mean, sir? Another very senior person making a statement, very embarrassing for Pakistan. Does Pakistan abduct foreigners for ransom?
Well, I don't know who this person is, what he's saying. At this moment, there is certainly some turmoil going on within Pakistan. And there is a total difference of views on many issues. So I don't know this man, which party, which group he belongs, and why he said anything of that sort.
He's a former ISI chief. Do you at least agree that Kulbhushan Jadhav, since you want to talk about him, should have been given consular access by Pakistan? That's plain violation of international convention.
Well, no comments. I don't know the exact diplomatic protocol on this. could have been given yes. But later on, I think the relatives were allowed to meet him.
And we all know the circumstances of how that happened. But let's talk about the political scene in Pakistan. And coming back to the 2611 attack and the perpetrator, he's been making giant strides even though...
What were the circumstances?
The circumstances were that Kulbhushan Jadhav's family was heckled, sir. It is extremely shameful for anyone to be treated in this manner by state agencies. The lesser said, the better.
That is what he says.
There are pictures. There is a video.
That is what Raw does. Listen, that is what Raw does and pollutes your mind. No, there is no video at all.
I have seen a video. I'll show it to you. I'll send it to you.
Pictures are not lie. These things are all cooked up to malign ISI, to malign everything.
Kulbhushan Jadhav's family was given access to meet him under dubious circumstances,
you know,
and
that
they were treated very badly by the system. I don't want to get into a slanging match with you. I don't want to argue on something that I know is factually correct.
Who says that?
I've seen pictures.
I'm asking.
The world has seen pictures, sir.
I'm asking you, who said that? You're raw. Your people said that.
Pictures beamed down in Pakistan.
Pictures get
that.
Monitored. Don't you know that? They can be doctored.
But these pictures came out of the Pakistan government and establishment. Did
they can all be doctored.
Show themselves in bad
they
light.
Can be doctored by Raw.
You have a lot of faith in Raw's ability.
Raw doctored them and gave them to you. Oh. And you are misled.
I suggest you go back to see those pictures.
Yes.
If you've not seen
I have
them,
faith
I will send
in
them
the ISI abilities, but I also have faith in Raw abilities.
That's very good to know.
Send the pictures, but I'm not going to believe them.
Okay. Let me talk
about you don't believe any because you don't believe anything that Pakistan says.
I believe in fact. I believe in numbers. I believe in proof, as should everyone else. And there is ample proof of what Pakistan
I believe in facts
do.
Also.
Yes.
Yeah, I believe in facts. You don't know facts as much as I know. So don't compare yourself.
So enlighten
with
us,
me.
Sir.
I know facts much
enlighten
more than
us,
you.
Enlighten us then. Tell us who was behind the 2611 attack.
I will. Not the Pakistan government, not the army.
Then, Hafiz Saeed?
Why are we talking about it? I should then start talking about what you are doing in Kashmir.
Why are you
fully concentrating on Pakistan?
Because you are a Pakistani and you have been the president
Hafiz
of Pakistan.
Hafiz Saeed is a Mujahideen leader and he... Yeah, I will tell you. I've been talking of Hafiz Saeed myself.
Sure.
This organization was sprung up in 1990. And they have been, they have sympathies with Kashmiris. Mm. Because of what you are doing in Kashmir. Because of how you are killing and carrying out genocide of Muslims in Kashmir. And now also in India. That is why these groups spring up. And they want to fight against you. I've been saying that openly. And he is one of them. Lashkar-e-Taiyaba is one of them. But you, the difference of opinion, you call them terrorists, we call them Mujahideen.
India is a sovereign country. It doesn't need intervention or help from anyone, least of all people who've been called designated terrorists. But you've spoken very highly of Hafiz Saeed. You've said that you're a supporter of Lashkar-e-Taiba. What do you think of his political debut, his impending political debut in the elections that are due in Pakistan in 2 months' time?
He may be a globally... First of all, I don't believe he's a terrorist. Hmm. Because whatever is happening in Kashmir, where he is involved, he hasn't carried out any terrorist attack anywhere in the world or in Pakistan. He goes into his organization, are volunteers to go into Kashmir and fight the Indian army. So we don't, I will repeat, because I have said it 10 times. There's a difference of opinion. We think they are Mujahideen. They are fighting for the rights of their Kashmiri brethren who are subjected to genocide. So we are not thinking that they are a terrorist. They are Mujahideen. Mm-hmm. And they are trying to get the rights of the Kashmiris. You are denying them the rights. So who's a terrorist? I don't understand. And as far as the world is concerned, designated, I know how these functions. I know how resolutions are passed in the United Nations. If you have a good clout, and you are linked with the some important countries of the world, you can get a resolution passed there.
But Pakistan are very good. Cloud, it was friends, so-called friends with America. Now nobody seems to support Pakistan.
I know how United Nations function, much more than you.
Nobody seems to support Pakistan because of this very delusional ideology that you all seem to support. Friend,
but now, No, it's not delusional. Mm-hmm. It is very practical. It is very correct. You are on the wrong.
I see.
You happen to be now strategic partners of you when you are saying that they have been friends with us.
Mm.
You are their strategic partners now against some global outlook of yours in the future.
I'll come to the strategic partnership. I'm going to cover all those bases, but right now I want to talk about Hafiz Saeed and Lashkar-e-Toiba and the fact that he is making a political entry. Is this the Pakistan's army of launching a coup without a coup, of getting more power without any accountability?
No, nothing of the sort. I mean, here is a group which is the biggest NGO, welfare organization, by the way.
Mm.
When we had this terrible earthquake in the northern areas, the best NGO was Jamaat-ul-Dawah of Lashkar-e-Tayyaba of Hafiz Saeed. When we had floods in the Sindh, the best NGO was again the same. So this is the kind of people they are. They have never joined hands with Al-Qaeda or Taliban. They are not those. They, in fact, he is against them. I know that. So we are trying to push a people who are, for as far as we are concerned, they are not terrorists, and we are trying to push them to the wall. So because they're falling there are all religious youth. We are trying to push them towards the Taliban and create more trouble for the whole world, for the region, and for Pakistan, and maybe for you. Unless we recognize that they are not, they want resolution of Kashmir. Why don't you sit on the... We were trying to with Mr. Prime Minister Bajpai and Manmohan Singh. So why doesn't it happen now? Sit on the table.
It's interesting
discuss,
that you. It's interesting that you keep going back
that
to Kashmir. That seems to be your favorite subject. You don't want to discuss anything else. I think this is the sole sort of point of interest of a Pakistani
yes.
politician in election season. Talk about Kashmir, whip up the anti-India sentiment. Is it the biggest thing that Pakistan cares about for a country that is on the brink of bankruptcy?
Yes, indeed. Sir? Yes. Yes, absolutely. Forget that. We were doing better than you in my time for 9 years. Leave Pakistan alone, we'll do better than you. Let me assure you. We have all the potential.
Mm-hmm.
All the potential and all the resources. It is different. If the government is non-functional and the leadership
Pakistan's
is weak,
Pakistan's debt to China is 60% of your GDP.
We are at a downward slope, but we will rise.
How? By launching attacks on India?
I'm not here to justify. I don't want you to interfere in Pakistan. You talk of India first, okay? Why are we? Is this interview just to malign Pakistan?
It is not
I'm
to malign.
To
I want to discuss everything
you
else. You keep
Pakistan.
Going back to Kashmir.
Pakistan
you keep harping on Kashmir.
Issues.
So I have to bring
we'll
these things up.
Resolve those issues.
If I want to discuss India, I'll discuss it with an Indian
yes.
leader, not with you. With all due respect, sir.
Because it is matters, certainly. Then I will not discuss Pakistan with you.
So what are we doing here? Anyway, let me ask you then. You've called yourself
Kashmir
a...
Kashmir is the critical issue.
Okay.
Therefore, we have to go back to it.
All right. It is election season in Pakistan. You've said that you're a supporter of Lashkar-e-Toiba. Reports have said that you even want to ally with the Lashkar-e-Toiba. Last year when I spoke to you, you said that you're looking at a comeback within a year when the conditions are favorable. What exactly are you waiting for? Are you waiting for an assurance, a word from somebody? What is a favorable condition? This seems like waiting for Godot.
Well, I don't want to answer that. I have my views.
Mm-hmm.
I have my strategy in my mind, and I'll execute it, and you'll know it when I do it.
But you will participate in the electoral process? It's 2 months away.
Well, let's see. Let's see if the conditions are suitable, I will.
Shed some light, sir. What are suitable conditions?
Well, I don't know how to tell you. It is confidential.
Okay. What about Nawaz Sharif? Was he the target of a witch hunt by the army? Was he punished for trying to, as many in Pakistan have put it, cozy up to India?
Well, no, not at all. But certainly when he cozies up to India, it is not liked by the public of Pakistan.
How do you measure what the public of Pakistan wants? Do they only want anti-India rhetoric? Or do they want jobs, electricity, roads, food, peace?
That is exactly. Listen, Palki, this is exactly what India does. Please see the reality. It is Indian government, the Prime Minister of India, your ministers, your generals, who work up the public and create a euphoria against Pakistan. In Pakistan, nothing of that happens. In India, it is a religious extremist party which wants to carry out genocide against Christians and Muslims, which is in command, it's in government in Pakistan. No religious party ever has been in government in Pakistan. And there, look at your own government, who they are and what they are doing. And then you are trying to advise us on extremism and terrorism.
Okay, let me tell you about my own government and the Prime Minister. He's been ranked number 9 on the Forbes power list. The only Pakistani who's made it to that list is the Army Chief, General Bajwa, who's at number 68. India is called an economic powerhouse, one of the biggest markets in the world. Pakistan is called an indebted country on the brink of bankruptcy. Where is the comparison?
Don't teach me how the world functions. The world functions on your own and your group that you have joined, and they are the ones who distort facts. They can be negative against one in one day, they will be positive on another day. This is what happened. So therefore, and when you talk of ninth and all, my book was on the New York bestseller list for 2 months.
So
the book that I wrote, and it contains a lot on Kashmir.
Okay,
so
I'll read it.
I mean, you are trying to tell me that Modi is so great that he is ninth.
You keep comparing India to Pakistan. I'm saying this because you keep digressing, sir. But let me come back. Let's look at Pakistan. Let's look at the future. Don't dwell on the past. Let's look at the future.
No, I don't digress. I have to butt in. You are saying that I keep digressing. No. When you leave the past, and you're talking, yes, he is now popular. I'll agree. I agree. He is popular in India, certainly. He may be doing well for India. And in the world, he is popular. Yes. But do not ignore the fact that this was not the case in the past.
Okay. How is he perceived in Pakistan? Let me understand through you.
No, he is not liked, certainly. Because you are carrying out genocide against Muslims and also Christians.
Do you know what is Pakistan's record on minority persecution?
The Muslims
persecution?
In India are scared today.
Do you know what is Pakistan's record on minority persecution, sir? When Pakistan became an independent country, the population of
Hindus
was 15%, now it's less than 2%.
These are all nonsensical figures, all right? Gujarat happened, or when you broke down or dismantled the Ayodhya mosque, not one shrine was touched in Pakistan.
I see.
What are you talking? Who feeds you this information?
You don't like facts, but let me tell you something.
Yeah, you don't know that? Not one shrine was touched in Pakistan.
Because there weren't many left. There's one Hindu temple in Rawalpindi. But coming back to Narendra Modi, he's close to President Trump. You said that India is now America's strategic ally. He has put a reset in motion. He's reset ties with China, which was considered Pakistan's all-weather friend. He's on very good terms with the Russian president, who made a departure from convention, came to see him off at the airport. While none of these people, none of these countries seem to be supporting Pakistan's terrorist-driven agenda, they're all backing India. Do you believe that Narendra Modi, in a sense, has taken away all of Pakistan's trump cards?
You are living in a delusion.
Am I?
Every country has national interests. If you see the national interest of China and even Russia today, it does not at all, it is not at all in sympathy what strategic path that India is following. Let me tell you that. And Pakistan will always remain friendly with them. They will always be friends with Pakistan. So don't be under any delusion.
But they're not giving aid to Pakistan. American aid is drying up. China is cracking down on the terrorist agenda. China has sent a lot of signals to Pakistan
that?
While it's investing a lot of money.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Now, I was telling you something.
Yes, sir.
You were
please,
talking
please,
of China and Russia.
Please go ahead, sir.
You mean China will be on your side when you are with the United States? When you have strategic links with the United States to do what? To contain China. So they are You think they don't understand these things? That they can never be friendly with you, or you will never be friendly with them? So what are you talking? Don't be under any delusions. Understand future strategy.
I understand strategy. All I'm trying to say is that the Pakistanis seem to be delusional because the American aid is drying up. Russians can only sell weapons, but you don't have the money to buy those weapons. The Chinese are putting in a lot of money, but that money comes with strings
attached.
Doesn't
matter.
Pakistani economists are saying this is a debt trap. As I said earlier, 60% of Pakistan's GDP is the amount that it owes to China as debt.
Yes, well, all these things are there. I agree with you. We are suffering. We have problems. We have problems of leadership and governance, global governance. But since I believe that we have total potential and resources available in Pakistan, which we proved in my time of 8 years, I have no doubt that a change in Pakistan will bring us back on the onto the path.
You believe
as
a change is impending, sir?
As far as aid to Pakistan is concerned, certainly we are getting aid and we should put them to the right use.
What would be the right use? Spending it on the military?
We will spend it in on the military as long as we ensure our security with the last individual and last drop of our blood. We will spend any amount of money to stop you from any aggressive attitude towards Pakistan. Remember that.
Good luck
and
with
Pakistan
that.
Can do it. And Pakistan has the resources. We'll still come back on to the track. Yeah, good luck. You dare not do anything to Pakistan. Let me tell you that. Your Prime Minister Modi or one of your
Dubai.
Ministers
You're
came on the
Dubai.
Television
believe,
the other
you,
day. I was
believe,
listening to
do you believe
that
Pakistan
we have divided Pakistan
this?
Too.
Let me ask you something. We've seen elections
Even
in
what?
India
time
and time again, General Musharraf, and Pakistan invariably comes up. The anti-Pakistan plank is a plank. How big is it in Pakistan? Does it get votes?
Much lesser than you. Much lesser than you. That is what exactly your leaders do. They work up frenzy against Pakistan in the public. And they do that with against Muslims and Christians.
Okay.
Nothing of that sort happens in Pakistan. Nothing of that sort.
So then why do leaders harp on it? They should talk about Bijli Sadak Pani, as we say in India. They shouldn't talk about India. They shouldn't talk about Modi. They shouldn't say that Nawaz Sharif is now
they
an
do.
Indian agent.
That,
and
is, that is the
Modi's
main
language.
Subject. Listen, they also say that, but their main concern and the main thing that they talk about is exactly what you've said.
Okay.
The people of Pakistan, I mean, they are 60-70 people living in Pakistan. They are concerned with their daily lives. They are not concerned with Modi or India. They don't talk about it. You work up frenzy. When your minister comes and sits and we'll break Pakistan into four now. This is what he says on the television. How dare he say that? What is he talking about?
The man you were just defending a few minutes back also says that we will make India bleed through 1,000 cuts and so on and so forth. I don't even want to repeat what Hafiz Saeed has been saying. You also blame Nawaz Sharif for the Pakistan Army's withdrawal from Kargil. Do you want to tell us more?
Of course I blame him. And plus the pressure that you, Indian side, put on United States President Bill Clinton, asking him to tell Pakistan to withdraw. Or these two combined, and President Bill Clinton listened to you, and he put pressure on Nawaz Sharif. That is how we withdrew.
So
otherwise, we were very well dug in there. You knew about one position, and we were in five positions inside India.
So are you saying as Army Chief, you were taking orders from the Prime Minister of Pakistan?
Yes, of course.
Let me come to another episode that you've been speaking about, or you've been quoted as talking about, when asked about Benazir Bhutto's assassination and collusion between the Pakistani establishment and the Taliban, you've been quoted as saying, there is a possibility, yes indeed, because the society is polarized on religious lines. Are you saying that the army and the Taliban had a role in her assassination?
Not at all. What do you mean by polarized? Then you are conjecturing that the army has a... No, it was the terrorists' supporters who carried out the assassination. I know that. They are the ones who were carrying out bomb blasts in Pakistan.
These are your words I'm quoting, sir.
Yeah, yes, I've been saying that many times. I'm very clear, Baitullah Masood is the one and his group of TTP, Tehreek-e-Taliban Pakistan. they carried out the assassination, and they are terrorists in Pakistan also.
Okay, there's a statement that Nawaz Sharif has made, something that he's also said in the court documents, and I'm quoting, a message was sent to me from the chief of an intelligence agency that I should resign, and if that is not possible, I should go on a long leave. The demand for my resignation or going on long leave was based on this impression that if Nawaz Sharif was removed from the way, it wouldn't be difficult to wrap up the case against Musharraf.
These are self-imagined issues that he talks of, and there is no truth in them.
He said it in court, sir, and then to a press conference.
He may have said it. Well, he says many things in press conferences which I don't want to get involved in. We are tackling the situation in Pakistan, but he cannot be taken on his word. That is all there. He distorts.
You keep saying we. Who is this we? What role do you have to play in the establishment in Pakistan right now?
Did I say we? In what connection did I say we?
You tend to say we. Anyway, one last question before I let you go.
I did?
Yes. If given a chance to be at the helm of affairs again in Pakistan, sir, what would you do differently and what would you do to A, lift your country from the shambles it's in right now and reset ties, if possible, with India?
I did that in 1999. Pakistan was being declared a defaulted state and a failed state in 99. Our foreign exchange reserves that were at $300 million, FDI was at $400 million. We raised it to billions and billions. How did I do that? Well, I will repeat it. I will first of all set the economy right in Pakistan. I will give to the people of Pakistan confidence in themselves. I will look after the welfare of the people, and I'll develop the state. And I will develop its security against all threats. That is what I'll do for Pakistan. And it is doable. I know it. I did it in 10 years. Now, as far as India and Pakistan, I do believe we must live in peace. I've been saying that I'm a man of war. Yes, I've worn a uniform to fight. But I am a man for peace. I know the ravages of war. That is why I'm a man for peace. We want peace with India, and don't be under the wrong notion that military is the one who wants war with India. No, we want peace with India. Army, I can give you a guarantee that army wants to resolve all its disputes and wants peace with India. And that is what we were trying. And the whole army and the whole nation supported me when I was trying for peace with Prime Minister Vajpayee and Manmohan Singh. I want to repeat that. And I see it was my initiative of the four-point agenda that we were following for peace in Kashmir. It was my idea,
okay, which
we were following. And we were drafting a joint resolution towards that. So this is doable, all that. But we don't clap with one hand. We can't do it alone. Mr. Modi has to join. The government of India has to join.
He made the first effort, sir. He invited the Prime Minister of Pakistan to his swearing-in ceremony.
He's made the moves.
I don't want to get into it again. We know what happened to the man who tried to respond to Modi's overtures. He's now been disqualified.
These are artificial issues. Listen, Palki, don't tell me these super... Please don't give me these superficial and silly... somebody calls you for birthday and so... But that doesn't matter in interstate relations. I can call Modi Saab 100 times to my house, come and have tea with me.
Okay.
What does that matter? Has he changed his mind towards Pakistan? So don't quote these things. These are trivial matters.
It's interesting how you brush aside whatever doesn't suit your narrative and your agenda. But I'm going to leave it at that. General Musharraf, always a pleasure talking to you, sir. Thanks very much for joining us here on WION.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.